Welcome to the Google Workspace Developer News, where we share what's new to the Google Workspace platform. We have 9 topics to cover, so let's get started. The AppScript Rhino runtime has been deprecated as of February 20, 2025. While scripts that run on Rhino will continue to work until January 31st, 2026, they will no longer function after that date. If you still have scripts running on Rhino, please migrate your scripts to the V8 runtime before this date. Please refer to the page linked in the description of this video where you will be guided through migrating your script to the V8 runtime. The Google Drive API now supports folders with limited access, which allow you to restrict folders to specific users. This change to the Drive API better aligns API behavior for items in My Drive and in Shared Drives, which was announced on February 18, 2025. To limit access to a folder, developers can set the Boolean Inherited Permissions Disabled field on the Files resource to True. Developers can also opt into expansive access API behavior in My Drive ahead of any future mandatory enforcement by setting the Enforce Expansive Access Request parameter to True on the Permissions.delete and Permissions.update methods. Please check the blog post linked in the description of this video to learn about the dates the changes will be enforced for everyone. When using the Google Meet API, all meeting participants can now query for certain conference data, including the conference records, the conference artifacts, and the participant records. Let's say a meeting participant wants to retrieve a specific Google Meet recording. You could use the GET method on the recordings resource with the name path parameter. The method returns an instance of a recordings resource. You can now pre-configure auto recording, auto transcripts, and take notes for me within a meeting space. You can also pre-configure these settings either when you create a meeting space or once the meeting space is created. This feature also lets you use these settings for meetings created from Google Calendar. This feature is available through the Developer Preview Program. Don't want to miss out on any Google Workspace platform updates? Then hit that subscribe button right below this video. You can now use a new non-sensitive scope to set up auto artifacts for meetings created by other apps, including Google Calendar. This new scope, which you see on screen, is available through the Developer Preview Program. The Google Meet Media API is now available through the Developer Preview Program. This API lets you access real-time media from Google Meet conferences. This API enables a variety of use cases. Here are several to give you an idea of how you can use the Meet Media API. Feed video streams into a sentiment analysis model, giving users real-time feedback on how other participants are receiving their message. Feed audio streams into an agent that performs real-time AI queries on the topics discussed in the meeting, occasionally interjecting with helpful suggestions. Or, using participant metadata, build an AI agent that acts as a meeting host, moderating the flow of the meeting agenda through awareness of who is speaking or present in the call. Please check the developer documentation to get started with using the Meet Media API. For the Reports API, Google Chat now supports the customerUsageReports.get and userUsageReports.get methods. 48 new Google Chat activity events have been added to customerUsageReports, and 4 have been added to userUsageReports. Please see the links in the description to access comprehensive lists of these new metrics. For the Reports API, a new event type, Conversation Read, has been added to Google Chat along with 4 new event parameters to activities.list and activities.watch. For example, you can use the new event name Conversation Read to get a list of the last 10 Google Chat messages. Check out the full list of events and parameters supported in chat audit activities linked in the description of this video. Our team recently launched a Jupyter notebook that shows you how to connect Gemini 2.0 Flash to your Google Workspace data to create your own productivity coach. The notebook guides you step by step as you go installing the Google Gen AI SDK, setting up your Google Cloud project to access Vertex AI, configuring the Google Workspace API's access, and more. You'll find the link to the Jupyter notebook in the description of this video. Please hit that like button if you enjoyed learning what's new to the Google Workspace platform. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in next month's news video.